Shoo! What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? We've got a special video for you playing. We're at Walmart. We're going a little co-op. What's the word? Special op, spec op, special op operations.
Sure.
Sneaky.
Sure.
You're usually kinky boy. You're sneaky boy today.
Really?
Yeah. Banjo said go. He says go up, go in the back door. So that's what we're doing. Anyways, what we gotta do at Walmart though? Safety first, folks. We've got some new toys. Okay. All right. I'm not gonna hide it. I was gonna hide. I'm not gonna hide it. We got some Rambo bicycles. Okay. And these are fully electric bicycles. We've got two of them. So the reason why we got these, because they're silent. It's like the golf cart, but a lot smaller, easier to kind of maneuver. Look, we got one strapped in back there. We got them for the ranch. As you guys know, the terrain at the ranch is just, it's all hilly and you can only get in, you know, certain areas with even the golf cart or even just an ATV. But there's so many places we haven't explored. So we got to think, we're like, how could we explore it without physically having to walk miles and miles and miles to shed hunt, to, you know, scout, to do whatever it might be. Well, then I'm like, I've seen some dudes rip around on this. So I hit up Rambo Bikes. They sent a couple over. And so we're gonna show you guys what they do basically today. And if you guys want any of them, they'll be linked down below. If you guys see what we do today, think it's cool and want to check them out for yourself. But we ripped them around by the house, and I'm gonna say, like, these might be game changers, folks. Okay, it's like, never, we thought the golf cart was a game changer, which it is, but getting in to tight places, especially like hiding it after, I'm like, okay, cool, you take a golf cart to the tree stand, where the hell do you put the golf cart? Okay, the deer, that thing, you just lay it down in the grass and boom, it's gone, it vanishes. So we got to go inside. We need helmets. We don't need any workers comp claims.
No.
Especially after the ATV incident.
Yeah, that was bad.
So we don't need any accidents on my watch. Don't need Banjo trying to get workers comp out of me. He's tried that once or twice before, and I'm not gonna let that happen. So we're gonna go inside Walmart, get some helmets, some safety gear, and then we're loaded up. We got the whole stretch. It's just Banjo and I. We're soloing because we only have two bicycles, and Zach's he's just got his wisdom teeth taken out, so he's MIA for a few days. So anyways, we're gonna go inside, get some helmets, some safety gear, probably get yelled at by Karen, so stay tuned for that. And then we're headed out to the ranch. We do have some chores to do. It's not all fun and games today. Well, I mean, I enjoy the food plot stuff, but we have to kill some grass, cut some grass, kill some grass, kind of prep for some food plots out at the ranch. You guys stay tuned. Oh yeah. Dude, I haven't worn a helmet for so long. Oh, that's a light up helmet. That ain't gonna fit you.
That looks so cool though.
You like that?
Yeah.
Look at that guy. What size do you think that is? Does it tell you? Oh, it says age five plus.
5 plus.
So probably not quite. That's an 8 plus. Okay. There's 14 plus.
Man, look at that one.
Oh, that one slaps. I like that guy. Where's, like, they have adult stuff here? Or how's this go?
I feel like this one.
A 14 plus is probably, I want something that looks cooler than that.
Oh, they got some cool ones up there too.
These are probably all for smaller noggins. Yeah. I mean, your head's not that big. Try putting that sucker on. Lice is a myth. You got it.
Really?
Yeah, you got it. Oh, you're fine.
Yeah.
Like, do you think it would save you in a crash, or is it just for looks? You look good. I feel like you gotta rip it.
Really?
Buckle it up, see what happens, see what it looks like. Is it gonna fit? You confident that you won't die? I mean, because, like, honestly, there's a good chance one of us will crash today. If we're crawling up the hills, the rocks, it's basically like biking in the mountains. You're not a fan?
No. I gotta get this one.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I like this one.
Is that one big enough, you think? That's a Raska. Who? What's it say? Rascals?
Oh, that's smaller, even.
Oh, so is that 5 plus? Yeah. Yeah, so you have an 8.
So, yeah, I think I might be ripping this 8.
You think you're ripping Big Daddy 8?
That or this one? I mean, this one is probably the most X10 wise, but.
It doesn't look as cool, though.
No, really?
We should attach some of these. You like that?
Yeah.
I say we gotta get some accessories. What accessories do you want for these suckers? We gotta find some cool accessories. I don't know if they have anything cool over here. All right, so.
Like knee pads or what?
Oh, dude, we might have to strap up in the knee pads. Yeah, I'm not trying to get a bruise. All right, put that on, see if that's any better. You mean hold this?
Bigger.
I kinda wanna rock this guy though.
I know.
He looks way cooler.
That definitely feels a lot better.
Was the other one not very comfortable?
No, the other one like squeezes your head.
Really?
I mean, this like fits.
That's like legit?
Yeah, but.
So you're not gonna die?
It doesn't look very cool.
Here. Let me put this guy on.
It's a little
God.
Tight.
God, yeah. I mean, I'd definitely still die if I crashed.
Yeah, that's what I'm feeling like.
Oh, I'm sorry. I kind of like it, though. Dude, I didn't think I just gave myself a concussion.
Like, I guess that was... Yeah, I know, dude.
Oh.
Dude, I did that. It hurts so bad.
Dude, that hurts. Like, that hurts worse than just hitting a bare head.
Now, do it with this one.
Oh, dude, I think I might have a concussion. I might pass out. Why'd that hurt so bad? Like, that's worse than without a helmet.
Do it with this one. It doesn't hurt at all.
Like, that's got to be the opposite effect of a helmet. That actually hurt. I don't know why. Yeah, that works a lot
better.
Yeah,
that one's bad.
That's got it. So kids would die if they wore that. There's
I'd
no way.
Not wear a helmet.
Yeah. What about this though? These look way cooler. This is like sporty, right?
Yeah.
Like this is like you're basically Lance Armstrong. You put this sucker on. God. It's not bad. You think you like that one better?
Yeah, those look cool.
Oh God, dude. These have no padding. The only one that feels good is the one that doesn't. It looks like freaking Tony Hawk with that sucker on.
I still think you should get this one.
I wanted something cool.
Look at this one. You could like write something in it.
Really?
Yeah.
He broke it. I don't know. I'm not feeling like, if I'm talking about actually not dying, that's not it.
Like, do you think they have another section that we're just missing?
Yeah, where's the, no, this is bike stuff though.
I know.
Like, where's the adult bikes? Dude, this one feels good.
Yeah.
All right, I feel like we have to just get this. I apologize. I wanted something cooler, but they don't fit. None of the cool ones fit. So I guess we're just rocking the normal helmets.
Bruh, that's like a Tesla.
How much for you to jump on it?
What?
Never seen that?
Who's driving?
I've never seen that.
You don't
that.
Go to Walmart a lot.
Yeah, I go to Walmart a lot.
At least you don't rip those suckers. Are you driving that? You don't have a remote control? Really?
Dude, that's Tesla.
Yeah, I see that all the time.
Freaking Elon's everywhere, dude, I swear. All right, anyways, we got helmets. See you guys at the ranch. Made it to the ranch, folks. There she is in all of her glory. We got two Rambo bikes. These are the bushwhackers. So basically going through the thick stuff and they don't get all tangled up. But that's kind of the fun game. So we're going to wait for that. We do have some chores to do. First things first, we're going to go fill up all the feeders with some protein. We got the mule and we've got a whole bunch of next level protein. We've already got the mineral down. We got a whole pallet. That's all protein right there. Tons of it, like literally thousands of pounds. So we're gonna back it up. We do have the golf cart here, but you just can't transport a ton with this since like it doesn't have like a full on bed. So we ended up bringing the actual mule. So we'll back it in, we're gonna load up and we're gonna run around. We've got three feeders, as you guys know, and fill all them up with protein. Cause right now they're only filled with corn since we didn't have protein for all, but now we got a whole pallet. And I think every single month we're gonna get a pallet like that. So we should have more than enough, especially for just the ranch. But hopefully we can get some more feeder set up at my house and the farm and stuff like that. So we're gonna back this sucker up, get her loaded. We're gonna drive out, like I said, fill all the feeders, get all that done. And then we're gonna kind of scout where we're wanting to do the food plot. And then we have the skid loader here, which is right over there. How's that going?
This door sucks.
Yeah, I know, I don't know why that thing is broken.
Come fix it.
Yeah, we need it. If any of you guys wanna fix the door, you let me know. But we got skid loader, so we'll cut the grass. Banjo is on spray duty, and I'm on cut duty. Ideally, if I can just mow a path, he can follow me with the sprayer, and we can mow and spray at the exact same time, and just get it done really quick. We're not 100% sure where we want all the food plots, but we're pretty sure where we want at least one of them. Just kind of like right in the middle, kind of by the pond, kind of by the hill. It's like one long ravine. It's where that green blind was. If you guys are OG viewers that have been watching since we got the ranch, it's the green, where the green blind used to be. So we're gonna do one there, and I'm gonna kind of hold off for the rest until we kind of figure out what we're doing. We've got a like deer habitat management guy named Dylan that's gonna come out in July, I think, and he's gonna help us pick like more specific stuff. Like, okay, you put a tree stand there, you put your food plot there, and you make a trail over there, and you when you come in on a north wind, you come over, like specific stuff. So we don't want to do a whole lot until he comes down, in case he's like, why'd you put a food plot there? It's not gonna work because of A, B, C, and D. Because I'm new to the deer hunting game, so I'm trying to get some advice from some wily vets. So there's one spot that I'm like pretty sure we could put a food plot, especially because they put a blind there, the previous owners, meaning they didn't put that there by accident. So we got the ATV. This is the OG ATV. If you guys saw the video of us crashing the other ATV. So this is the ATV we've got dangling. We got to take this box out. So we got to take this, take the toolbox off, put the sprayer on here since we crashed the brand new ATV that we were supposed to have for the ranch. Oh, well, that'd be Banjo's doing. So good job. Don't do that today because we only have one ATV left. I do have another ATV on order and we're going to fix the other ATV. So it's not like, I should have three, hopefully. If we need to, we can throw some mineral bags up here to weight up the front. So we got to get the toolbox. Yeah, only, no hills. Yeah. No hills allowed. So we might actually have to go through some gates to get from here to where the food plot is some steep hills. So we're not dealing with that. We'll take this, guys. So we got to take this off, put the sprayer on, get it filled up with all the Roundup styles. It's not actually Roundup, it's just glyphosate and some water and spray. But sorry, that's the plan for the day. And then, once our chores are done, me and Banjo are going to go bicycling. Is that the right word? Exploring with bicycles. Wherever. Like, there doesn't even have to be a trail. That's what's gonna be cool. So my goal is to get to the top of a couple of the mountains. I call them mountains, they're not mountains, but just really big hills that are rocky and they look like mountains. I wanna go where no man has gone before. Okay, that's the goal with these suckers. We'll bring you along with us. We're gonna have some head mounts and cameras. We'll have everything. We'll take you guys along for the journey. Maybe we'll find some cool sheds or bones or skulls or something like that. So anyways, that being said, let's get the protein loaded up inside the mule. First spot, actually right by the shop here, as you guys already know. We gotta get this sucker filled up with that good stuff. Grow them antlers and whatnot. How, pretty empty, huh? I can see the light through it.
Yeah, it's all the way empty.
Pretty much empty, huh? We've got a little mineral. Yeah, oh yeah, they've been stomping on it. Got some mineral there. So we put 10 pounds per month per site. But we just did this like last week. So, well, let's get her filled up. One, how was that? I needed to get you a little closer next time, maybe.
Yeah, I felt like I was about to fall.
You almost died, but five bags? Yeah, is that what it was? Died. Five bags in. Let's go do the rest. That's how two beefcakes fill up feeders. I would say we average about a minute per feeder, honestly.
Yeah, that was pretty productive.
We crushed. The first one took some time. We're getting it dialed in. Two people. Goes a lot faster than one. So, feeders are filled. This is what we were using, in case you're curious. It's the next level deer supplement. This is the spring summer deer pellet, which is basically just really good protein that's going to help the does who are carrying fawns. And then when the fawns are born, they're going to munch on it. And as well, of course, you guys already know, the bucks are going to eat, and they're regrowing their antlers right now. And it basically just, I thought you're about to just take a nibble. Like you almost look like you were about to bite.
I mean, it does smell pretty good.
It doesn't smell too bad. So it's just a little protein stuff. It keeps a healthy herd growing. They bulk up. They're just overall healthier. There's a lot more science to it than that, but that's basically all you guys need to know about it. Is you need to have it. If you're trying to manage a herd of deer and you're trying to grow big antlers, big bodied, have really healthy herds, you got to feed them stuff like this. Real good stuff. So they're all filled up. We got three of them done. Those are the main three. We're probably going to add some more here soon. We're just trying to figure out where we want to put stuff like mineral sites and stuff like that. But we're gonna go scout. I think the food plot's gonna go up there. So for those of you guys who know, it's the south side. The pond is right over here. It's right across the ridge. This is that real long skinny section that runs all the way up. There's like that green blind. Then you can get to the top, which is where that green feeder used to be. Trying to let you guys know kind of where we're at. I know everything kind of around here looks the same, but we want to go kind of, I just want to make it around this corner a little bit, because I think we could probably set a blind up somewhere over here. We could access it over there, and we're gonna have a pond over there. We're gonna be there a lot. We don't really want the deer right here because the pond's right there and we're gonna be fishing, making noise. We don't really do much up that way. So let's head up there. We're going to scout, see if we can find any boulders, rocks, sticks, stuff that wouldn't go that great through my lawnmower, and kind of get those moved. Just kind of get the site prepped, essentially. So we'll see you guys up there. Shoo! We made it. So right where we're down around, or basically down and around that corner is where that last feeder was. So this is kind of where we're thinking. So there's like a little brush pile here, but here's a stretch. But you can see we could get all up in there, like a nice pocket. You get a nice pocket here, and then it gets narrow up there. So we're trying to kind of decide how big do you make it. I'd reckon it's like 2-ish acres, 1.5 to 2.5 is kind of where this is. We could keep going and going and going and make this like a huge long strip, but I like the idea of it kind of being a bowl shape. So you could hunt almost, I would say 360, like you could put a tree stand up in that thing and then you could shoot anywhere over here. So I think this is probably where we're gonna go. We just need to go look for some rocks, make sure I don't break anything. We made it, folks. Banjo's on a big business meeting. He's sitting in that meal just talking to somebody important. I don't know. Anyways, we got the skid out here. We kind of just spent the last hour kind of prepping everything. We got the sprayer attached to the ATV and all the boring stuff you guys don't care about. But the cutter is here. I've got to basically cut 2 acres. Okay, so from here to where I'm stopping, I measured it on the maps. It's a 2 acre. So here, as you can see, there's a brush pile like beyond that quite a way. So I'm going to be floating around this area. I'll probably just try to cut here to the brush pile first. I think I'm going to start kind of at this tree because we've got a feeder right over there. I'm not really sure about planting there just because the pond's right there. We're gonna spend some time there. I'd rather keep the deer not super close to us if we're gonna be making noise and whatnot. But I think probably draw a line here and just cut from here to the brush pile. See how long that takes. I mean, it's probably at least double, maybe triple that. So like what you see here, this is probably maybe 3/4 of an acre. And then we've got another 3/4 and then maybe another quarter. I don't know how many quarters I just said, but 2 acres is what we're talking about. So let's get to cutting. We got got about 3/4 of an acre done. You can see it looks good. I feel like it's like, man, this is, look, before, after. Look at that. Banjo's excited. He's killing it over there. So you can see we got, I mean, it's rough, but that's fine. It ain't your front lawn, folks. This is just get it cut down so when we spray it later, it already looks freaking dead. When we spray it, you're not spraying as much. It's easier to kill once you mow it. And it'll have like less thatch, if that's right, where kind of just dead material like this type of stuff. It'll have less of that because that'll decompose by the time we plant. So we got this section done. Now we're gonna bump over to where that brush pile is and probably do another 3/4 of an acre. And then we may jet up there and do a little bit more. But it's really not taking long. That was like, I don't know, 20 minutes or something. I kind of took my time. I kind of went around. This next one, I think I'm gonna trim the edges and then shoot down the middle and do it like you would do your lawn where you're just going back and forth like this. Because I think when I'm like doing this, it seems like it takes a little bit longer. Maybe not, I don't know. Let's get to cutting. We got most of it mowed. Banjo just brought the old ATV and he's ready to get some spraying. So we got all that done. I still need to clean some of this up and we got all that stretched done. So that's pretty much end to end is almost mowed. I need to go kind of clean some stuff up. I mean, this is, look what we're dealing with. See, we'll have to pick all this stuff up before we plant. But ideally, once we spray the grass, it all should really die down. Then we come through and pick, you know, just have the mule and throw some wood in it. So I'm gonna go kind of clean this up. Banjo's gonna start spraying. He's just gonna start kind of getting everything sprayed down on that side and then make his way up on this side and get everything sprayed and we should be done. Hopefully. Banjo gets all this sprayed. I get the rest of it mowed. We should be good to go and then we can explore with the electric bikes. Stay tuned. Done, folks, finally. That took us way too long, but this was the hardest one. Now that it's all clear, once we get these sticks picked up, you know, next year if it needs to be mowed, we bring in one of the big tractors, the big bat wing mowers or something like that. This was just like, this is the equipment I had, so it's gonna make it work. And I mean, it just took us an afternoon. It took a couple trips, three tanks. And I think one tank was supposed to do all this, about 2 acres, and we put 3 on it. I just wanna make sure it's dead. It better die. If this grass is still alive, I'm gonna be freaking pissed. But that is all done. It's all cut. I cut it all the way up. There's like a path that shoots up that way. I cut it all the way up. So we're, I mean, at least 2 acres, 2.5 acres. And I don't know. Like, I don't know if we're going to plant the whole thing. The whole thing is going to die regardless. I mean, we may end up putting some switchgrass in if we don't want to put a food plot in a certain area or whatnot. But this is, again, kind of like the big obvious section where it's like, this could be good. You've got the creek there. You've got the high ridge there. The pond's back there. It just seemed like a good area. Plus, like I said, the previous owners had a blind at the end of there. So they had that there for a reason. So everything's mowed and sprayed. I know that's not why you guys came here, but I got to show you guys the progress at the ranch. Step one, getting food plot out here. It's complete. Let's go ride some bikes. Sheesh.
Ready to shred.
Save some for the rest of us, my guy. Really? Easy there, bud. Well, we're strapped up. We're taking you with us via GoPro on the head. We're ready. We got the work out of the way. It took all day. It's like 5 o'clock. Chores, freaking chores. But it'll be worth it if we smoke old. You haven't even shot a deer. I think you got to make it personal and shoot your first deer off that plot just because of how much work we just put in.
A spotted one.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you probably shouldn't do that. Plot's done-ish for now. More than likely, we're going to have to go back and spray it twice just because, especially because we were like kind of spraying it in spots rather than like one long continuous back and forth. So I'm sure there were some spots that got not sprayed too great, but like I said, we put like almost triple the amount of, you know, weed killer, grass killer that was recommended. So I hope we got most of it, but we'll probably end up spraying it again in July. Anyways, you guys came for these guys. These are the old Ram bikes. So I didn't show you how this sucker works. You jump aboard. Oh god. Oh my nuts.
Dude, they're too tall.
I'm not. I need to lower my freaking seat. All right. So you hit this power button. Look at that thing. It's like a freaking Tesla. Okay. So then you hit this button and that makes it go faster. So there's like, it's on 0. Now it's on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 5 will pretty much go like, and then this is the throttle. So you see that? But the cool part is if you just start pedaling, it automatically kicks in. So you can either just use the throttle or you can, like, it can just assist you. Or you can go full-blown no motorized if you're just trying to crank out a quick leg workout, which is not the case today. So
what is this, like, does yours say 4 over?
So you're supposed to shift gears.
Oh, what gear? I was in 4. What were you?
I don't know. I think that's if you're just using it as a normal bicycle.
Oh, so what's yours in? Does it matter?
Where's it tell you at?
Mine says 4.
On this thing?
Yeah.
My whole thing is like, it's too low for me. 5?
5?
It says 5.
So I'm in 5th gear?
Yeah.
I don't know if that... Maybe I'll put it in 0 and see what happens if I can shift it or not.
Okay.
I'd assume like electric kind of overrode that whole thing. I could be wrong. I should have read the instructions on this sucker.
We don't do that.
But we're ready. We're strapped. Safety first, folks, okay? Don't be like Banjo. And...
Oh, we can track how far we go.
Oh yeah, I got 0.9. How far are you going?
1.1.
So 1.1 miles?
We'll see how far we go today.
Really? Okay, so...
I don't know how to...
You just left it right there, though?
Yeah, I don't know how to reset the trip. I don't know how to work this thing.
I'm not sure to work this thing yet. I probably should have. What does this thing do? Okay, this is sick. Okay, it says how many calories, okay, how much time, how far your trip has been. So I'll restart. I'm going to reset the trip.
Max speed?
Yeah, hang on. Let me reset the trip. I assume that's how you do it. Oh, maybe not. Odometer. 0 miles. 14.7.
Oh, boy.
How fast do you go?
22 miles an hour.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we're definitely not breaking that today. But,
nah.
Okay, this thing's kind of cool. So how do you, I'm trying to reset my trip. That way we know how far we got. I mean, I've only gotten 0.9. Mine says 0 miles. Oh, so it's pretty much 1 mile. Okay, anyway.
That's right. We're babbling. We're about ready to start shredding. Whoa, I don't know what I did, but look at my screen.
What did you do there? That's got all sorts of...
Speed limit, 60 miles an hour.
Really?
Heck no.
I'm all right.
I just like double tapped it.
Oh God, yeah, I did the same. Okay. Okay. Oh, I see. Okay, trip reset. Okay, let's change that to a yes. Yes. Clear.
Information or display setting?
Display settings. So I cleared the trip, okay. Dude, this is like a freaking, this is literally the
Tesla of bikes.
And the best part is it's for hunting. It's not just like, hey, we're taking up bicycling. Is that how you say that? Riding bikes for a hobby. Like this is for hunting, folks. So we're gonna get our sea legs, so to speak, ready for these things and start meandering around. Like I said, ideally I'm gonna start picking trails that are like straight, cause we're about the width of a deer right now. I'm gonna start picking deer trails that we've never taken an ATV on or nothing like that and take you guys in undiscovered places. Hopefully we find something cool. Stay tuned. All right, ladies, here we go, boys. So you hit this up button to 5. Oh God, dude, I'm not even pedaling, bro. I'm not even pedaling. Oh gosh, look at this thing. It's literally just off the throttle. But then you start pedaling and it just starts going. Like, look at this, it's just going. Look at this thing. Oh my God, we're cruising, we're going 10. Okay, slow down, Jim, slow down. I'm trying to die. Okay, we'll keep it at level 3. Okay, that's a little tough, maybe not level 4. All right, here we go, where's Banjo? There's Banjo. Bro, it looks so funny. Like, I don't know why, this is just funny. All right, well, we're ready to explore now. We're entering Jurassic Park gate, so now you guys kind of know where we're at. Whatever you do, don't slam on the left brake. All right, let's see if we can find a path, some type of trail around here. Okay, oh, I found a deer trail. All right, we're following it. I'm one with the deer right now. Okay, I lost it. Okay. Oh, there's a raccoon. What the heck? Did you see big goat? Hey, come here, Jim. Oh man, I should have been strapped. That son of a gun. What was he doing in broad daylight? No, he couldn't. He let us get real close. Oh, we're back on the deer trail. All right, here we go. Where is this taking us to? Oh, golly. I've never been over here. Hang on, what is that? There's a tree stump? Yeah, it might just be a big tree stump. All right, here we go. Oh, hey, tree, how you doing? You have thorns? Most of my trees around here do. Come on, okay, come on. There you go, you got it. Oh, God, there's, okay, hang on.
No?
No, we're fine. You might just have to walk a little bit here. There's a big tree. Okay, resets to 0 if you stop.
Yeah, when you stop, it goes back to 0.
Okay. Oh God. Okay, this is definitely not a trail. Okay. It's all right. Just gotta walk it now. Okay, my gooch is about to fall off. Look at these thorn trees. Okay. Here's what we're gonna make life easier. These damn thorn trees. Easy, pal. Okay, I might have picked one of the tougher trails here. Okay, we're gonna go down here. At this point, we're just hiking. Okay, get back on the wagon here. How you doing back there, Big Jim?
Good.
Okay, this is not a trail. We gotta get back. I think we gotta get back down on the main drag here. Okay, yeah, okay. Okay, yeah, there's not a deer don't even come over here.
Bro, you got a whole tree in here.
Yeah, I got a tree through the spokes. That's probably not good. All right, here we go. We're getting there slowly but sure. Hopefully these tires have good thorn resistance. Okay, yeah, definitely, there's no trails here. There's not nothing. There's not even a deer trail. Look at that big ass tree. That'd be a nice tree for a treehouse. How you doing back there?
This thing crushes.
We haven't gotten stopped yet and we're not going on any paths at all. You see how big this tree is?
That thing's huge. Let's make a treehouse.
That's what I said, treehouse tree. All right, let's go find a deer trail.
Probably all poison ivy trail.
Yeah, this is definitely poison ivy. Okay. Oh, look, I'm wearing pants. Yeah, we're definitely putting these little suckers to the test because I'm running over a hell of thorn trees right now. So if they don't go flat, they got better durability than my side-by-sides. All right, we're in a small opening. This is good. This is good. I'm okay. I still don't know where I'm at. This is good. Oh, huh?
I feel like I'm going to die.
Nah, you got it. Look at this guy.
There we go.
I see a path that way. We're going that way. Good. Nah, there's a log right there. Okay. Well, we hadn't fallen off yet, so this is good. Okay, that's a literal tree. Okay, all right, just ran over a tree. All right, we just gotta get to this opening. We're doing it. Oh God, that's a log. That's a whole log. Watch out for that log. Never in my life did I think I'd take a bike through this. Look at this. Now we're cruising. Banjo's killing it. Woo! I'm like literally pedaling right now. This is crazy. Oh, here's a trail. Okay, found a clearing, Banjo. Oh God, there's some big ruts right here. Oh, watch your head. I gotta kick it up into fifth. Woo! Oh, look at this. Oh, this is awesome. Woo! Look at that.
Have you ever been here?
No, we're on the top of the mountain right now.
I will say, if you hit a log and then you go back on this, oh,
your gooch gets it, huh?
That was cool trail.
I wish there wasn't trees here because you can see forever. There's cactus right there. Look at that. Oh, yeah. All right, I think we're at the, yeah, oh, yeah, now you can kind of see the view.
Yeah.
I think we're at the top of the mountain on the east side.
Yeah.
Like, we're at the tip top. Yeah, this is crazy.
There's no way you get an ATV or anything up here.
No, this is awesome though.
Yeah.
So we go that way and hit the fence and then shoot back up? That'd probably be a lot faster.
Yeah.
All right, let's go down. We've never been down this trail, so let's see if we find anything cool. Oh, downhill's nice. Look at all these rocks.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, this is why we wear helmets, because these rocks would not feel good on the old noggin. Goodness. Yeah, don't do that. Just take it easy. I just let it rip. That was a little sketch. Yeah, the rocks are a little, the rocks are sketchy. We haven't fallen yet though. Look at Banjo, he's killing it. Freaking Lance Armstrong over there. All right, now we're a little bit more flat. This is good. Oh, see, this is big chilling cruising now. So for those of you guys that want to know kind of where we're at, we're on the far east side. Like, look at, like, this is just like desertish looking. It's just all rock and I don't know. It's just really weird.
Yeah.
I guess it's just the top of the mountain just has a little bit different terrain, but we've gone 0.3 miles, Banjo. All right, there's not a whole much of a trail right here, but try to make this work. We've got to make it to the bottom. I think we'll find the fence, and then we should be able to regroup and go somewhere else. But we made it to the top of one mountain. That's one big accomplishment I haven't been able to do, is get on the top of one of these little suckers. All right, now we're cruising. I ain't seen any sheds yet. This is definitely like I don't even know what do you call it? Oh, there's a rub right there. Or scrape for deer.
Really?
Scrape right there,
oh, yeah.
Right on the ground. I say this is what do you call it? Uncharted territory.
Big,
I doubt anyone's been over here. I'm looking for sheds, but I don't know if we'll find any. I'm gonna go over here. Okay, I kind of know where we're at now. There's another one right there.
Oh yeah.
So it's a bare spot and then there's a tree limb above it. That's the old scrape. So there's deer over here. I mean, someone had to have knocked all these trees down, right? Okay, this is not a trail. Flipper 180. I saw a gap to hit the fence. You a big number three guy?
Staying three?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I've been staying in.
Yeah.
I don't know if the shifting actually matters. All right, here we go. Oh, the deer are so screwed this year, boys. Some silent warriors out here. Yeah, I know where we're at now. We're getting there. Oh, okay, I know where we're at. Oh God, those are thorns. Those are all thorns. Oh God, rip, out. Those are all thorns. Hopefully I don't hit a pothole, I'm screwed. All right, look at that. We made it to the fence, folks. So now we're on the far east side. And this path got cleared when we took this fence down. Oh, look, when it's cut grass. Oh, let's crank her up to five. Let's see what she's made out of. When the grass is cut like this, like I'm not even pedaling. I'm just letting this thing freaking rip. Oh, this cut grass is nice. Without pedaling, I'm going 9 miles an hour uphill in grass. This is the deal. So what we need to do is just cut some trails where our blinds are gonna be in tree stands. And then we just access them via bicycle. Like, this is just an absolute game changer. It's so quiet, it's easy to hide. Oh, this is great. Oh God, big rock. Big rock just blew my gooch out. That was a doozy there. Hey, it's so weird riding a bike and not pedaling. I have not taken one pedal since we got on this flat ground. I'm just seeing what this bicycle is made out of. This is awesome. Oh God. Big logs. Dude, this thing cruises over logs better than my golf cart. Good night. Oh, yeah, there we go. This looks like a path I don't think I've ever been down in. Should take us hopefully close back to the cabin. There's a scrape right there. We're cruising. Oh, okay. Oh, that's kind of where we started. Got it. So we actually popped out by the shop. Look at that. Dude, these are wild. It's kind of a workout, even though I'm not even hardly using my legs.
My hands are...
My hands, from gripping so hard.
Yeah.
Yeah, my hands hurt.
Like,
I know.
It's been like a mile.
Yeah, I went 0.8.
You gotta tell me what your max speed was, though.
Probably not very fast, like 10, I'm guessing.
Sheesh.
Shoo! Wow.
We just got back. That was a good time.
That was fun.
It was a good time. We got to one side. We don't want to explore everything. Honestly, we're beat. We're tired. We didn't eat lunch. We're ready to go home. The chores took it out of us. But if you guys want to see us more exploring videos with these guys, let us know. And remember, if you want to check them out, there'll be a link down below. This is the Rambo Bushwhacker. If you want this exact one, they have a bunch of other models, different price points for different stuff. What are you trying to look at here?
I'm seeing who went faster, obviously.
Probably you.
Ooh, I got 13. 11.6.
I was going to say, I don't think I went much above 10.
Did you go in fifth?
But that wasn't pedaling though.
Yeah.
I never pedaled when I was going fast or whatever. Yeah. I think it was in fifth is where I picked up that speed. But we said, these things are freaking dope. I'm excited. Now it's kind of the end of hunting season, so there's not a whole lot of usage here as things, you know, get closer to hunting. I mean, honestly, hunting season is pretty much around the corner. If you think about it, we're like, okay, well, it's May-ish, right? June, July, August, you have 3 months, and then September's bow season. So I mean, really, it's not that far out. It seems really far. It feels like we just got done with hunting season. But these guys are the newest edition of the toys. We got a lot of work done. It was a good day at the ranch, Banjo. You crushed it, my guy.
Oh yeah.
It was a good day. Good day's work. We're tired. We got so much equipment down here now. We got side by side, we got a four wheeler, we got three trailers, the skid loader, two bikes now, the golf cart's inside there. Yeah, anyways, we're gonna load the skiller and we're gonna head out. We're gonna head home. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. It was just, you know, another ranch day. Nothing super, super, super exciting, but I can't leave you guys hanging. Gotta keep you guys up to date on everything we do at the ranch. And if you have any video ideas, like maybe Walmart survival challenge, overnight survival challenge, whatever, like you can't hunt and our pond don't have any fish, so we need some help. Give us some creative video ideas in the comment section down below to do at the ranch. We'll catch you on the next one, and peace.